Welcome, gamers, to the first test server session of the new year. I hope you're all doing good. And yeah, let's start the new year with the first test server session right now. So what's new? The King of the Hill mode is back. This time, I guess, after nobody had any clue how this new mode should work, Pixonic provided a instruction for it. So what is the game mode like? From the 5 beacons on the field, only one is activated at a time. Every beacon holds the same number of points you can gain from it. How to gain those points? First, you have to conquer the beacon, and then you have to stay near the beacon. This is the fact. It doesn't make sense to conquer the beacon and to run away. Then you will gain no points for this beacon. You have to stay near, and the longer you stay with the beacon, the more of the points this beacon holds gets to your counter. When you lose the beacon to the enemy, the rest of the points the beacon is holding goes to the enemy. The more of your own people or of your own teammates stay near the beacon, the faster those points the beacon holds comes to your counter. So the more people stay there, yeah, the faster the game could end, probably. Same with the enemies. If the enemy counters the beacon, the more enemies are near the beacon, the faster they gain the points. After all the points one beacon holds have distributed to the teams, this beacon is deactivated and another one activates. So, yeah, and you can win this game either when having enough points, when the time runs out and you have more points than the enemy, or last way to win, destroy all the enemies. This is something I don't like at this, in this mode, because most people, as you will see from the fight afterwards, most people use this mode also as team deathmatch, so they are not concentrate on the beacons like some do on domination, when they only want to kill the enemies. Yeah, that's a little annoying. Yeah, okay, but what else is new? Yeah, one topic is, of course, the Spectre again. The stats have changed slightly. Pixonic decided to increase the health points from 78,000 to 86,000. Speed is still the same, 53 kilometers per hour. The cooldown has decreased from 20 to 18 seconds, so you can use this jump and stealth called Descent more often, but the stealth mode no longer stays 5 seconds after the jump, it only stays 4 seconds, so you can use this ability more often, but the time it lasts isn't that long anymore. And the jump distance has been increased once again after it has been decreased last time. Yeah, this is the Spectre, so you can see here the three different setups, one with Orcans, one with Terrans, one with Scourges. Then you can see here the Dragoons, and this is also a topic of this time's test server session, but the numbers haven't changed at all. It still has a range of 550 meters and yeah, does 4800 damage points on level 8. I have chosen to put it on a Fury and the other time on a Natasha. The Natasha I have chosen because the Natasha has also two light slots, and these I have equipped with the new light weapon Arbalest. The Arbalest is in my opinion, a mixture between Trebuchet and Dragoon, because you have the same range as the Trebuchet. You have 1100 meters of range and you can charge the weapon like a trebuchet, but only for 7 seconds, not for 20, or for 5 seconds, not for 20. You need to charge it 2 seconds in order to fire the lightest shot, 7 seconds for the heaviest. But the beam and the frequency of the shots looks like the Dragoon, so it's for me it's a mixture of those two weapons. Let's have a look, close look at it. You might have seen this weapon on the official Facebook page of War Robots of Pixonic, or in other posts on FB. So yeah, this is the new light weapon Arbalest. What I can do, we will see in the fight. And yeah, as this is all for today's topics, we can go directly there. Here we go. We are playing on the Dreadnought map. So what's to choose first? Yeah, let's choose the Natasha with the Dragoon and the Arbalest because I can do some damage on a bigger distance. But Natasha is not the fastest bot in the hangar, so what you could see by now, the Dragoon is more accurate than it was the last time. Last time you had to really get the enemy into target. This time it's enough to bring the cross into the square. As you can see, we gained lots of points while my teammates were near. This guy uses the dune to hide behind. So I have to get away from that open structure here. Okay, this wasn't a good idea. Yeah, you have seen the Arbalest. The first shot did more damage as the weapon was charged. The shots afterwards were in the same frequency as the Dragoon, as I said before. Yeah, and you have seen we could turn the first beacon blue at first. Some of my teammates could stay near, so we gained lots of points. But then the enemy conquered the beacon and they got the rest of the points the beacon held for us. So, and after all points were distributed, the beacon changed to this place. And as you can see in the circle on top, there is not endless time to conquer that beacon. There's a counter, and also the points you can gain gets less the longer you need to counter the beacon. And as you could see, my little mate helped me to get those points a lot faster than it would have taken when I would have been alone. So yeah, this was pretty cool that he stayed with me near the beacon. And now you could see the massive damage you can do with the Dragoon weapon. This is nearly ridiculous. Yeah, this time I'm lucky. My teammates have understood how this game mode works. Also, this guy stayed near the beacon. And made it possible for us to gain the points. Now the beacon switched over to spawn point to the home spawn point of the enemy. So this is normal. Next will be the oh yeah, and now you could see the power of the Zeppelin again this time. Hurting me, doing some damage to my robot. Yeah, 4 or 5 shots in the back and you're done, so yeah, that's pretty hard. Oh, this guy decided to ditch his bot. Yeah, no problem with that. I got in range of the Dragoon again. As you can see, this really hurts very much. Not again. This guy killed me twice. I won't let him do that a third time. As you can see, no one of the enemies took the beacon, so the time is running out without gaining any of the points. This is hurting so much in this Dragoon weapon. This is nearly ridiculous. Yeah. Unfortunately, I ran out of bots, so I have to only watch the game. But I can, yeah, I can do my resume already. Yeah, my resume is the. This mode, as it works now, does much better than last time, and if you have the right teammates, this mode is really can be really funny, yeah. But as I told you from the games I did before, I got to know that not all your teammates care for the points you can gain from the beacons, so sometimes they make a team deathmatch out of it, so yeah, that doesn't make really sense, but some gamers play that way. Yeah, the Dragoon, as you have seen from 3 of my deaths, I always died from Fury Dragoon mixture. Yeah, it's way too overpowered, way too overpowered. You only need 4 or 5 shots in this constellation to bring down a Spectre, a Carnage, maybe you need 6 or 7 shots to bring down a Griffin, but that's way too overpowered. This is way too low time, way too low shots to bring down an enemy, so yeah, that doesn't make any sense to me. You've seen the Spectre again, yeah, also this bot is way too overpowered. You can jump, you can shoot, you can bring down an enemy easily. We have seen I have brought down this lance nearly within a second before I got shot down by this dragoon. Yeah, this is just. Yeah, as you can see, this butch has also died within seconds, being shot from Dragoon and from Taurans. Just as I said, both is way too overpowered. The only thing that is, yeah, nearly balanced to me is the Arbalest, this medium weapon. You've seen the charge shot at the at first, then you have seen the shots that looked like the Dragoon shots, and this weapon does not do too much damage in my opinion. It has lots of range, so this is enough for this weapon. 407s per shot is okay for me. Yeah, and by now we have won this game, so let's have a look how I could do. I don't get any. I can't see. Ah, at least I've got 3 gold and did 624 of damage. So this means I got gold for second place. Yeah, this was quite okay. Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't show you the chart, so you have to only. Yeah. I can only give you information. I must have been second in my team, so, and I wasn't the one that got the most of the beacons. This is all I could give you by now, but I could give you information I want to give you. You have seen all of the topics I wanted to show you, so yeah, I hope you liked this video. I hope you got informed about everything that is happening on the test server and that might come to the real or to the live server soon. If so, feel free to leave comments, feel free to subscribe to my channel. I'm gonna keep you informed when you do so. And yeah, nothing more to say then. Bye bye, next time, we'll see you again. Bye.